friends, it's Meredith. Welcome back. Welcome if you are new, and a big shout out to all my new followers. Thank you so much. I am thrilled that you are here and appreciate everyone who has been following me since the beginning. I just appreciate you all so much. And today I am going to have a little kind of a crafty sesh with you and show you how things are coming along in this gorgeous journal I'm making with some of the papers from Amity Bloom. So many gorgeous papers to choose from. So do check her out if you haven't had a chance to do that already. So I was inspired by her latest journal. I believe it's called A Story Within Her. I could be wrong, but I will link her flip through and then tutorial of how she has put together this no-so style junk journal. And just super fun. This is my interpretation of it. I've used similar digitals that she has in her creation and, you know, put my little spin on it. So without further ado, let's jump in and I will show you kind of the bones of where things are at. And I have attached a couple of the signatures already, and I will show you how I'm going to do that with the remaining two. And then we will attach, this is my back cover, and we will attach that as well. So just to kind of share a little bit about how I decided to assemble this. This is the top cover, which is not attached yet because I am going to attach it to this front piece, probably with some lace and some kind of trim. So this, I created this little nice journaling card, and I actually may back that with something. Haven't done that yet. And then this beautiful smaller image of this antique book is just so stunning, and I absolutely love it. I applied, so the paper I used to print out most of the images and papers is the linen paper. I will link it below. I just bought it on Amazon and I love it. And I attached it to some cardstock, and then this is another one of the digitals as well, but I just love the texture. And it ages really well. Mine is the white linen, not the cream. So I, for some reason, the white was half as much as the cream. So I figured, well, I'm gonna age it anyway. I might as well just get the less expensive model of paper. So this just clips on here, and I will probably, you know, add some other goodies there. So we will set that aside for now. And then I will show you this part of the journal is another beautiful image. And this flips down. And I know it's going to be hard to see all on the screen, but this flips down like so. And I will probably embellish this maybe a little bit more. And then when you close that up, this opens up to the first center part of the, I guess it's kind of the journal topper. And then this here is a little pocket. And then this is the larger of the images. And so here is kind of a sepia version. And then this is the actual colored image. And again, I added cardstock to this and then backed it with, you know, some other papers. I've also got some nice craft paper in here, and I actually bought this on Amazon as well. I will show it to you and link it below. It is literally just a pack of 50 craft paper, similar to your brown paper packaging, but I kind of liked the kind of more camel brown color than, you know, just your typical Amazon packaging, or, you know, what you get when you order something in the mail. And I, you know, you can distress it and age it. It's actually fairly heavy and thick, and you can easily put it through your printer, you know, just like a cardstock. So moving on, the concept with this journal is to attach your signatures without sewing them. So this is actually my first signature here. Let's see. Well, I'm going to just show you. So the way that she did it, she had a couple different ways, but this is just a strip of cardstock. And so the first signature here is attached to the back cover of this with this nice little band of paper. And you can make it as wide as you want. I could have also just taken this page and glued it on the back, but I really wanted to have, you know, both this image visible as well. And so this is the first signature. And as you can see, I have attached this book page onto the back of this page here. And same thing going through. And just glued it down. This is kind of what you would consider the center of the signature. I will probably add some, you know, embellishments in here, pockets, whatever. I haven't quite decided yet. And then moving forward, this is some craft paper that I attached with this strip. This is a beautiful, beautiful wallpaper image in the kit. I actually have used quite a few kits, so I will make sure I list them below. This is that craft paper, and then another sheet and this beautiful music page. And oops. Okay, so here, this is very fragile book page, so I'm going to actually need to reinforce that one right here. I'm actually glad that happened now and not after someone may have purchased this. I don't know if this is going to be for sale or not yet, so because it's a work in progress. But anyway, so moving forward. So this is another strip to attach the pages together. And I just use glue stick. You could certainly use fabric tack or any other, you know, kind of tacky glue. I have noticed that the pages are pretty stiff, which is totally fine because I like that, nice and crunchy, and you know, everything is feels really, really good and sturdy. But you know, with adding some of the strips, it does make it a little stiffer and a little bulkier, so just keep that in mind. So this is the second signature that we're going into now, and as you can see, there's another strip that I attached. And then this is kind of the center part. This one is so pretty. I think this is from the Aurelia's journal pages. I can't remember. But anyway, I know which they all are, and I will attach or, you know, list them below. I use some of her Poetic Petals pages in here as well. Some beautiful French ledger and just some miscellaneous coffee dyed paper that I had in my stash. And then here, this is the back of that white linen. You can see the texture is really cool. And I'll probably add, you know, something there as well. Okay, so this is the back part of the journal so far. So we have all our signatures attached, except for the one that tore that I'm gonna fix here in a minute. And the next one that I'm going to attach is going to go right here. So I will grab the things that I need and be right back to show you how we are gonna put the rest of this together. Okay, so just to show you, I fixed that part that had split off, and I think it's gonna be just fine now. So put another strip here. This is the beautiful pink French ledger kit. I just love it, super pretty. So that is all put back together. And so now I have my, where'd it go? There we go. So this is the back so far. And then now we are going to attach this beautiful signature. I'll just give you a little quick flip through of this. It's so pretty. And you can see here, I attached this page just with a piece of, or just, you know, by folding this paper and then attaching it here. And same thing here. So this is some book page, and I attached this sheet from that side, signature piece. And then this just kind of flips out here. And then this is a little strip that I attached to this short page. And we have some more of that craft paper. And this is a strip from the Soft Petals kit. And opening here, this is one of the beautiful wallpaper panels So I attach that like so. And if this kind of stuff bothers you, like so, see here, it's not like totally even. I actually kind of like that. It sort of makes it a little more scrappy and scruffy. And same with this, like I'm not going to even that off because I like that. But you can totally, you know, even everything out and have it all be very matchy-matchy if you prefer. There's some more of that gorgeous pink ledger on this side as we open out. And then this is the back panel for this signature. So, so pretty, those beautiful doves. Okay, so this, the My Love Song, is part of the Love Is kit. And I have this strip that I copied, made another copy, and then tore it here. And so when I go, oops, put back in there. When I go to attach this, I want to match up, because what I did is I took this piece on the back and I wrapped it to the front. So now I wanna have that be matching, and then I'm gonna attach it like so. That's the plan. So let me get some glue. I think what I'm gonna do is actually just put the glue all over this. And like I said earlier, you pick your glue of choice. I am just using glue stick, and I'm happy with that. But if you like the Fabri-Tac or the other types of wet glue, that is totally optional. So here I am going to lay that on pretty close to matching up. Press that down, and then I'm going to actually put the glue on this part, because I see how it's kind of tall because it's all stacked up. I want to be able to make sure that I can press it down evenly without having to totally do a lot of gymnastics. All right, so here I am pressing that down. And I love this because it did not cover up this beautiful lady. And I could have even trimmed this smaller, but because this is the back panel, I wanted to make sure that it had enough of a, you know, strip on there. And so now what I'm going to do is go ahead and just fold that in half and kind of give it a little bit more secure pressing. One of the things too with using a glue stick as opposed to a wetter glue is it tends to dry a little quicker, and so it okay. All right, so there we are now, fully attached to. So as you can see, the spine is growing, and you know, it's kind of raggedy and uneven, but that's okay, because ultimately, once I put everything together, this whole back part is going to be enclosed with some fabric and lace. So now we just have our final signature, and I really like how this turned out. I took the same kind of concept as I did with this side, is I took this beautiful Edith Holden sheet and kind of just wrapped it around on this one. And then I have some more of that beautiful tapestry, and so many pretty. This is from the Heirloom Rose collection. Super pretty. I think this is the soft petals, petal pink. I can't remember. Sorry, guys. My brain is a little off on remembering every single digital, because I just kind of grabbed so many of her beautiful kits and decided to just morph them all together. This is a little coffee dyed page that I made a little extension here. And then this is the back page. This is one of the, I think, Juniper Blooms wallpaper. I can't remember. Okay, so now that this is put together here, same thing. I have a piece that I am going to attach right here so that we can finish up here. So let me find my strip because for some reason it's not right here. So I will grab it and be right back with you. Okay, so this is going to be the piece that I use to attach this back signature here. And I think that'll look really pretty. So I am going to do the same thing I did before. And I had double side printed on my pages because I wasn't sure what I was going to use for what. And I just like to do that sometimes. So unfortunately, I'll have to save this piece, that part that I was going to use for something else. So let's go ahead and get situated. Okay, so now this time I'm actually going to put the glue on this part so I can see exactly where I need it to go. You guys are having a great start to your week. I don't even think I asked you how you were doing. I haven't done a video in a while besides just a design team share, so I'm a little rusty on doing these chatty kind of craft with me style videos, guys. Sorry. Anyway, all is good here, and I'm just gonna press that down. We got it all in the right spot. Just press it down a little bit more. And then I'm gonna fold it just to make sure we got it all lined up. And you know, making this kind of a journal, there is no perfectionism because you just never know how things are gonna work out, but I think I really like how that looks, and super, super pretty. Okay, so this part of the journal process is complete. Looks like I need to put a little bit more glue on that part, and then I'm going to figure out how I want to attach my back cover. So I haven't decided yet if I want to attach it to this so we can still see this page, which I definitely love, but I might just go ahead and have this be the back part with this just kind of peeking out. I might kind of crumple this up a little bit more because it does stick out a little bit further than maybe I had wanted to. Okay, so I'm gonna fuss with that a little bit. So let's just take a look and see where we're at here. So this is kind of what the journal is gonna look like, and you can see all the different layers and pieces in there. And I feel like this is gonna maybe be a two-part video because I have all these gorgeous ephemera pages. Let me show them to you. So this is all part of the Love Is kit, and they're so pretty, and I want to make some beautiful tags and cards. This is from one of her envelope kits. I absolutely love this. I printed this on that linen paper. And so many beautiful little sayings, kind of Valentine's, but not really. I think you can use love-related themes all year long. And then this is so pretty. Love this, and this beautiful. Might make a little mini journal with this, fold it in half, that'll be so cute. So I think we will end it here today, and I'm gonna pick out my laces and my binding pieces for the side so we can kind of make sure we like all of that. And then maybe the next video I do, either later this week or next week, we'll be stuffing this with all kinds of goodies. I hope this wasn't super boring. And leave me a comment below and let me know what you think. If you've made a journal similar to this before, or if you've never tried one, give it a shot. I will link Nazzy's awesome tutorial and her beautiful flip through of her journal that was my inspiration. And I appreciate you all being here today. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I will see you in my next video. Thanks. Bye.